Hi everyone, welcome back. Today is a dinner vlog that was taken quite some time back, even before my previous video, and it took some time for editing. Now, similar to my previous dinner party videos, I made this too into a vlog. Firstly, because I know just showing the recipes alone would be a little boring. And lastly, because if at all you are planning for the same menu, you would get an idea how to get ready and prepare on a timely manner. But many of you feel that it's a little confusing to get the recipes in vlogs. So for that, let me tell you the menu first. Since the weather here is chilling, I decided to give my guests a warm welcome drink rather than a cold one. That's orange tea. This can be served even at the end. It's up to you. Then as a starter, inspired from a restaurant we had gone on my birthday, made shrimp dynamite, my husband's favorite, and it was quite a hit on the party day. It was really yum. Then was a macaroni salad and labneh dip with cucumber and carrot sticks. Then for the main course was Chinese chicken fried rice. To go along with it was chili paneer. Usually I prepare rice rotis, but this time made fried rice rotis or rice puris, you may call. We call it puricha patiri. Then was mutton mushroom roast. For a curry, made my dear friend Shani's easy butter chicken, which she had prepared on a cookery show. You might have seen the behind shots in my video sometime back. As she suggests, butter chicken is the best to be served with Kerala parotta, which is the only item we ordered from outside. And as a dessert, served Oreo dates cheesecake at the end. Now, to prepare all these items takes little time and effort, but if you have some planning, it's easy. So hope you would like it. Keep watching. Now, for any parties, preparations begins the previous day. So for the shrimp dynamite, I had cleaned and washed 1 kilo prawns. These are large in size. Add that to a Ziploc bag, or you can take any storage box that'll fit in your freezer. To that, add 2 tablespoons of dark soy sauce, 2 tablespoons of chili sauce, 2 tablespoons of sweet chili sauce, and some salt. Mix everything well. Now, you don't have to marinate the prawns as such. The classic recipe doesn't use these at this point. I added for extra flavor. And that goes straight into the freezer. Now, I had 2 kilo chicken pieces. From this, I separated 1/2 kg of boneless pieces aside and used the rest for the butter chicken. Crush 1 whole garlic and few ginger pieces. Now again into a Ziploc bag, add the 1.5 kg chicken pieces. To that goes ginger garlic paste, 1 or 2 tablespoons of red chili powder and salt. This is for the butter chicken. The marination needs only 15 minutes before cooking, but to save time, I marinated the previous night itself. And that too goes into the freezer. Now for the fried rice, I had cut 1/2 kg boneless chicken pieces into thin strips. Into that goes 1 tablespoon of dark soy sauce and some salt. Keep that too into the freezer. I had even prepared the dates cheesecake the previous night because it needs at least 24 hours to get well set. And here I took enough dates that I didn't have to add extra sugar or condensed milk. The sweetness came from the dates and that was enough. But if you don't want to add a lot of dates, you may have to add sugar or condensed milk for extra sweetness. Here I took around 25 to 30 dates. Pit the dates. Soak it in some hot water so that it goes soft. Meanwhile, crushing some Oreo biscuits, around 15 to 20. I crushed along with the cream, which had little butter, but I suggest you do add 1/2 cup melted butter while crushing so that it gets well set. Mine was a little powdery as I didn't add any butter. So do add the melted butter. Line a springform tin with baking paper at the bottom and add the crushed Oreo biscuits and press it evenly. Keep in the fridge for at least 15 minutes. The dates are soft by now, so adding these into the food processor. If you feel it's too tight and thick, add the water the dates were soaking in and process again. It's done. Needn't be a paste, there can be chunks of the dates to have that bite while having the cheesecake. Into a mixing bowl, adding 250 ml of whipping cream. You just need to have soft peaks. Into another bowl, add cream cheese around 400 grams. I took 2 packs of 200 grams each. Beat well for 2 minutes. Add 1 teaspoon of vanilla essence and then the dates. Add 1 teaspoon cinnamon powder. Then fold in the whipping cream till well combined. Now take out the tin from the fridge. Add the dates and cream cheese mixture onto the biscuit layer. Spread it evenly. If you want, you can top it with some nuts or ganache. I kept it as such. Cover and place it back into the fridge until you serve the next day. Then next day, after kids had gone to school, I began after 10. First thing I did was soaking basmati rice, around 2.5 cups. My measurement is the condensed milk tin, which is 450 grams. You can do this the previous night, making ginger, garlic and green chili paste separately. I did on the day of party. Now that's the rice porridge for kids for lunch. They like it too and it's easy and time saving on days like this. I use broken rice, which is their favorite. Then putting all the vegetables in water for some time. Preparing the rice for fried rice. Adding 2 chicken cubes to the water, it's optional. When the water boils, add the drained rice and salt. Now for salad, I'm cooking some macaroni. Boil some water. You can choose any shape or any size. I took the smaller one. Just 1 cup. To the water, add 2 tablespoons of oil and some salt. The rice is done. Don't wait for it to become well cooked. Just 3/4 of the cooking is enough. Once the water is all drained, Spread it over a plate so that the grains are separated from each other. After the macaroni is soft and cooked, drain. Into a mixing bowl, I'm adding 2 triangles of salted cheese. If you don't get these triangles, just add 3 tablespoons of salted cheese. Then 2 blocks of cream cheese or 3 to 4 tablespoons. Mash well with a fork. Then add fresh cream, around 1/2 cup. Then 2 big spoons of labneh, or you can go for thick curd. 1 tablespoon of mayonnaise, 2 tablespoons of tahina, 1 tablespoon of sweet chili sauce. Whisk everything well. Then goes 1 or 2 tablespoons of honey or sugar or even condensed milk if you prefer. Some salt, 1/2 teaspoon black pepper powder, and mix well. To this add 1 cup of sweet corn, 1/2 cup chopped black olives, the cooked macaroni, chopping a handful of parsley. You can add coriander leaves or mint leaves if you don't have parsley. Mix well. If you want more creaminess, you can add more of either mayonnaise or thick curd, that's labneh. For extra color, I chopped up some purple cabbage and 1/2 of an orange capsicum. Mix everything. Cover and keep in the fridge until served. This is best when served chilled. Next is the dip. For that, I'm using 1 1/2 cup of labneh, or go for thick curd. Then goes in 1/2 to 1 cup of normal curd, 3 to 4 tablespoons of tahina, 1 1/2 teaspoon of green chilies, crushed or chopped, 1 1/2 tablespoon of crushed garlic, 1 teaspoon of black pepper powder, 1 to 1 1/2 teaspoon of paprika, you can skip if you don't have it, 1 teaspoon of dried red chili flakes, chop a handful of coriander and mint leaves and add. Mix everything very well. Just a squeeze of lemon juice or 2 tablespoons. Mix everything. Add some olive oil and fold in together. Garnish with chopped coriander or mint leaves. Now cover and keep in the fridge until served. While waiting for Rihan to come back from school, I am shallow frying the chicken pieces for the butter chicken so that I could give them a few pieces along with the rice porridge. After all the chicken pieces are fried, use the same pan, or if you're changing to a different one like me, use the same fried oil and some butter. Then add 2 medium-sized onion chopped, 1 tablespoon of garlic paste, saute for 2 minutes, and then add 3 to 4 small tomatoes chopped. Adding a handful of cashews and mix. Then add red chili powder, 2 tablespoons or less if you want less spicy. Then 1 1/2 tablespoon of vinegar. Mix everything together and saute for 3 to 4 minutes. Then off the flame and spread it over a plate to cool down before blending. Meantime, I'm adding washed and cleaned mutton pieces into a pressure cooker, that's 1 kilo. To that, add 1 1/2 tablespoons of red chili powder, 1/2 to 1 teaspoon turmeric powder, 1 1/2 tablespoon of coriander powder, 1 teaspoon garam masala powder, 1/2 teaspoon of fennel seed powder, salt, 1 tablespoon garlic paste, 1/2 tablespoon ginger paste. Mix everything well. cook the mutton on medium high flame until first whistle and then reduce the flame to low and cook for 15 minutes. Meantime, preparing dough for the fried rice roti or the rice puris. For that, I am taking 3 cups of rice flour. Chop 1 medium sized onion. Into a heated vessel, adding 2-3 teaspoons of ghee or oil. Add the chopped onions and saute well. Then add 1 tablespoon garlic paste and 1 tablespoon crushed green chilies. Add thinly sliced curry leaves. Mix everything and cook for 4 to 5 minutes. Then add 3 cups of water, some salt and let it boil. When it starts to boil, add the rice flour. Mix everything very well till it forms a dough. Off the flame, cover and keep aside. Back to the butter chicken. This mixture has cooled down completely, so add it into a blender. Add 1/2 to 1 cup of water and blend to a smooth paste. Add it back to the same pot. Add 1 cup more of water. Keep it back onto medium high flame. When it starts to boil, add the fried chicken pieces. Mix well. Then goes in 1 cup of fresh cream and adding some more water along with it. Finally, crushing some kasuri methi or dried methi leaves and add it to the curry. To balance the flavor, adding 1 tablespoon of sugar. For extra taste, add some butter. And that's done. Next, preparing the mutton mushroom roast. Slicing 2 large onions. Heat coconut oil in a kadai. Add the sliced onions. Add 1 handful of curry leaves. Then slit in 4 to 5 green chilies. Saute till the onions go really soft. Then add chopped 3 medium sized tomatoes and mix. Cover and let it cook in low flame for some time. Then chop 250 grams of button mushrooms. The tomatoes are really soft and cooked now. To this, add 1/2 teaspoon turmeric powder, 1 teaspoon of coriander powder, 1/2 to 1 teaspoon black pepper powder, and mix everything well for 1 minute or 2. Add the mushrooms. Add salt and mix well. Cover and cook in low flame. That's a quick bite of brownie for my energy. Meanwhile, I'm preparing the sauce for the shrimp dynamite so that I could mix the shrimps quickly for the starter at the time of serving. Into a bowl, adding 1 cup of mayonnaise, 1/2 teaspoon of dried basil leaves, 1 teaspoon of garlic powder, a pinch of oregano, 1 tablespoon of red chili flakes, 1 tablespoon sweet chili sauce, and mix everything very well. 1 teaspoon of paprika powder. Now, if you don't have any of these, 1 cup of mayonnaise and sweet chili sauce will also work out well. I have added the rest for extra flavor and taste. And that goes into the fridge. The mushrooms are cooked by now. Adding the cooked mutton into it. Mix till the water is dried a little bit. Chopping some coriander leaves. Cover and cook in low flame. Meantime, for the chili paneer, taking around 3 cups of paneer cubes in a bowl, add 1 teaspoon red chili powder, salt, and toss it. Add 2 tablespoons of corn flour, 2 tablespoons of all-purpose flour, and toss again so that it doesn't break. Make sure the paneer is well coated in the flour mixture. Then keep aside. The mutton is well done and it's ready. Now to coat the shrimps, add 2 to 2.5 tablespoons of all-purpose flour, 1.5 tablespoons of corn flour, 1/4 teaspoon of black pepper powder, some salt and mix. Into another bowl, break 2 eggs and whisk well. Add the marinated shrimps and mix well. Now take each shrimp and coat it in the flour mixture and keep it aside. It's always better to clean up the sink on the go, or else dishes would definitely pile up. Time for frying the paneer, so heating some oil. Fry till it's light golden brown color. After frying all the paneer, I removed the oil and kept only what's needed to make the chili paneer, around 3 to 4 tablespoons. Add 1 tablespoon of ginger paste and 1 tablespoon of garlic paste. Then a handful of spring onion chopped, then chopped 2 medium-sized onion. Saute for a few minutes. Then add chopped capsicum. I took half orange, half red, half yellow, and 1 small green. These are for colors. You can use any single color, it's up to you. Saute for 1 to 2 minutes. Add 1 tablespoon vinegar, 2 tablespoons of dark soy sauce, 2 tablespoons of red chili sauce, 3 tablespoons of tomato paste, and mix well. Half teaspoon of black pepper powder, some salt, and mix. Now this is a mixture of 1 tablespoon of corn flour and some water. Add it slowly into the mixture and keep stirring it. Then 1/2 to 1 cup of hot water. Balance the flavor with a tablespoon of sugar. Mix everything very well. Then add the fried paneer and combine well. Lastly, goes in the spring onion leaves. Mix for 2 minutes and the dish is ready. Now heating a kadai for frying the prawns, and on the other side getting ready to prepare the fried rice. It's always best to make fried rice towards the end. Adding some oil and butter. I had beaten 4 eggs here. You can use more or less. Add it first and don't scramble it immediately. Let there be big pieces of the egg scramble. Then goes in the chicken strips and mix till the color of chicken turns to white. Add 1.5 tablespoon of garlic paste and let the raw smell go. Meantime, on the other side, frying the prawns. Don't overcrowd. I fried 5 to 6 prawns at a time in my small kadai. To save time, I chopped all the vegetables in a food processor. I added carrot and capsicum first and mix for 1 to 2 minutes. Then a mix of purple and green cabbage. Mix for a minute. Added 1 chicken cube, which is optional. Do not cook the vegetables for more time. Let there be a little crunch. Then add in the rice and mix without breaking the greens. Finally, the spring onion leaves. Then for seasoning, add 2 tablespoons of dark soy sauce and 1 tablespoon vinegar. and that's done. That's the time. Guests will come by 8:30 to 9. Final is the rice puris. So into the dough, I'm adding a coconut mixture. You will have to grind a cup of grated coconut, 6 to 7 shallots and 1 to 1.5 teaspoon of cumin seeds. Add the coconut mixture and knead well. Knead the same way when kneading rice rotis. If the dough stick to your hand, dip your hands in filtered water and sprinkle some onto the dough. This way you can knead it very well till very soft and smooth. Take a medium sized ball, not too big or not too small. You can use a roti press or flatten it with a rolling pin or even press it with your palms. Make sure the rotis are thicker than normal rotis, shouldn't be thin. Deep fry in hot oil. After a few seconds, press on top, it will rise and then turn. Fry till golden brown on both sides. Finally preparing the orange tea. Placing orange slices into a pot. Add sugar, hot water, some cloves, cardamom and cinnamon sticks. Then adding some mint leaves. Let this boil for 5 minutes. And then add tea powder and then it's done.
I have just finished getting ready. Guests have come. Let me get started with the starter.
Now this was served first. Then mixing the shrimp with the sauce I had prepared. Add some cabbage leaves into the glass you're serving and add the shrimps. Then came the next and they all enjoyed the food. I always love to have food for myself after serving the guest. If at all there are any lady friends, I would definitely accompany. Final was the cheesecake. And that's for today's video. Hope you enjoyed watching it. If so, please give a thumbs up and don't forget to share among your friends and family. Do try out the recipes and I would love to hear your feedback. Send me in the pictures of recipes you have tried. See you again with another video. Until then, take care. Bye-bye.